Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the surface area of revolution of a parametric curve. So in this particular case, we've been given the parametric curve defined by the two equations x equals 1 minus t and y equals 2 times the square root of t. And we've been asked to find the surface area that's generated by revolving this parametric curve around the x-axis between t equals 1 and t equals 4. The formula we're going to use for it is given here by S of x, meaning the surface area found by revolving the parametric curve around the x-axis. And as you can see, we're going to be taking the integral from a to b, a and b being defined by the range here for t, 1 to 4. And then we have the integral of 2 pi y ds. Now, we need to make a couple substitutions. We're going to substitute for y what we have over here in this half of the parametric equation. So we're going to substitute 2 times the square root of t in for y. And then we're also going to make a substitution for ds based on this second formula over here for ds. Now keep in mind, notice in this ds formula we've got f prime of t and g prime of t. Well, when you're dealing with parametric equations, people will often use these interchangeably, but we've been given equations in terms of x and y, an equation for x and an equation for y. The equation for x is also f of t. The equation for y is g of t. And so when they say f prime of t and g prime of t, it means the derivatives of those two equations. So let's go ahead and start writing our surface area of revolution formula. So the surface area found by revolving the parametric curve around the x-axis is given by the integral from 1 to 4 of 2 pi, and now we're going to make our substitution for y. So we know y is 2 times the square root of t. And then notice we've got ds, we're going to make our substitution for ds, so that's going to be the square root of f prime of t squared. So f of t is the equation for x. F prime of t is therefore the derivative of the x equation. So the derivative of, we'll do x prime, the derivative of 1 minus t is going to be negative 1 because the derivative of 1 will be 0 since it's a constant, and the derivative of negative t is negative 1. So we'll get negative 1 squared. And then we'll add to that the derivative of g of t, which is going to be the derivative of our equation for y. So y prime, or g prime of t, is going to be, first of all, let's convert this. 2 times the square root of t is the same thing as saying 2 times t to the 1/2, because the square root of t is the same thing as t to the 1/2. So taking the derivative, we'll multiply 1/2 times 2. That, of course, cancels and becomes 1. And then we'll subtract 1 from the exponent, so we'll end up with a derivative of t to the negative 1/2, which we can convert to 1 over t to the 1/2 power, because that exponent becomes positive when we move the whole thing to the denominator. And now, of course, we can say t to the 1/2 is the square root of t, so this becomes 1 over the square root of t. So that's our derivative, so this is going to be 1 over the square root of t, and we're going to square that as well, and then we're going to add on dt to the end of our integral. So now everything's in terms of t, and it's just going to be a matter of simplifying what's inside of our integral, and then integrating and evaluating on the range 1 to 4. So let's go ahead and move a couple things outside of our integral. This piece right here, 2 pi times 2, of course is 4 pi, and that can move out in front of the integral since that's just a constant and everything inside of our integral is multiplied together. So 4 pi comes out in front, 1 to 4. We've got the square root of t, and then inside this larger square root sign, the negative 1 squared just becomes positive 1, and then 1 over the square root of t squared becomes 1 in the numerator, and the square root of t times the square root of t, of course, is just t. So that's what we're left with in our denominator. So now, if we convert what's inside of our square root sign, our second square root sign, 1 to 4, square root of t, let's talk about this square root here. So we want to find a common denominator, so we'll do that by transforming this 1 here to t over t, which is the same thing as 1, but now we have a common denominator. So this square root becomes t plus 1 over t. And now we can take the square root of those two things separately. We can take the square root of the numerator separately from the square root of the denominator. So this actually becomes the square root of t plus 1 for the numerator divided by the square root of t for the denominator. And as you can see, we're going to have two square root of t terms which are going to cancel. And we're left with now the integral of 4 pi times the integral from 1 to 4 of the square root of t plus 1 dt. And we can change this to s of x. We're going to change the square root of t plus 1 to make things easier for us to integrate. So remember how we said the square root of something is equal to that thing raised to the 1/2 power? We're going to take away the square root sign and say t plus 1 raised to the 1/2 power. Now we can integrate by adding 1 to the exponent, dividing the coefficient by the new exponent. So when we integrate, we're going to get 4 pi, and then this is going to be the start of our integral. We add 1 to the exponent, so 1/2 plus 1 is 3/2, so we'll get t plus 1 to the 3/2 power, and then we're going to divide our coefficient, which is 1, by the new exponent, 3/2, and we would need to divide by the derivative of the inside, t plus 1, as well, according to chain rule. But the derivative of t plus 1 is simply 1, so there's really nothing left that we have to do. So this is just going to be the end of our integral, and we'll be evaluating on the range 1 to 4. So now we need to do a little bit more simplification before we evaluate on the range 1 to 4. First of all, this 1 over 3/2 is going to become 2/3. So now we have 2/3 times 4 over pi is going to give us 8 pi over 3 times t plus 1 to the 3/2 power, evaluated on 1 to 4. Now we can go ahead and evaluate, first by plugging in our upper limit of integration 4. So we'll get 8 pi over 3 times 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 to the 3/2. Then we'll subtract what we get when we plug in our lower limit of integration. So 8 pi over 3, 1 plus 1 is 2. So we'll end up with 2 to the 3/2 power. And now you can use your calculator to find 5 to the 3/2 power or 2 to the 3/2 power. Or you can do it without a calculator by just kind of separating the exponents, or I should say sort of dealing with them in two parts. First, we'll deal with the numerator of the exponent, 3, and then we'll deal with the denominator, which is this 2 piece right here. Since these are fractions, we'll see something kind of cool in a second. So 5 to the third power is 125, so we'll end up with, over 3, we'll end up with 125. We dealt with the 3, but we still have the 1/2, so this is 1/2 minus 8 pi over 3. 2 cubed is 8, and we still have the 1/2 that we have to deal with. Remember that 125 to the 1/2 is the same thing as the square root of 125, so we'll end up with, let's factor out that 8 pi over 3 while we're at it. We'll end up with 8 pi over 3 times the square root of 125 minus the square root of 8. And now if we take the square root of 125, remember that 125 is the same thing as 25 times 5. 8 is the same thing as 4 times 2. So we can take the square root of the 25 part, we'll get 5. So 125 is the same thing as the same thing as 5 times the square root of 5. So we'll get 8 pi over 3 times 5 times the square root of 5, and then the square root of 8 becomes 2 times the square root of 2 when we take that square root of 4. And that's it. That's our final answer. If we want to put everything over 3, we can do that. We can say 8 pi times 5 square root of 5 minus 2 square root of 2 all over 3, just to make it one clean fraction. But either way, it's correct. So that's it. That answer represents the surface area of revolution that we found by revolving that parametric curve around the x-axis on the range 1 to 4 between t equals 1 and t equals 4. So that's it. I hope that video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.